Just само да направя phone call и ще ти кажа.
Just само направя.
So, is it possible to talk in Bulgarian because I feel more comfortable and more short?
Anyway, if you can note it, it's the most important that we keep in mind the idea.
Do you have some other right here?
Аз смятам, че под каквато да.
Без хартия и такова да мине.
Да.
Мама, this is feel staying in you, not in me. I wanted this for me.
Ако ще превеждаш, няма да мога.
Мото ще пишеш?
Мотото втърчило да са на едно място на една.
Ами, не съм сигурен дали това, което ти искаш да си напишеш е същото.
Аз просто
пиша. Добре.
Окей,
сега. Аз смятам, че ясно е, че се намираме в природна зона, екологична зона. Ясно е, че ще защитаваме традиции в едно такава бъдеща сграда, че ще защитаваме природа и така нататък. Това са неща, на които всички са минали през ума.
So she thinks that it's perfectly clear that we want to preserve nature and the cultural heritage and
history too.
The history and all these things that we all told about.
Аз искам да насоча вниманието към нещо, което е близо мое виждане. Това са нещата, които аз се занимавам в моята работа, ежедневие, учене и така нататък. За да работи въобще една такава общност, според мен тя трябва да бъде изградена на няколко етапа, освен тези, които са ясни като силни точки на общността, на града, като природа, традиции, история и така нататък. Аз имам други идеи.
In order for this community to work out, there must be a different kind of stages in which this process will happen.
Затова трябва да имаме различни, нещо като различни нива. Например, местните хора, те ще работят с това, което имат като свой ресурс, като свои знания. Аз смятам, че за да работи това нещо много добре, трябва да включим интензивно млади хора във формата на нещо като обмени. И тези образователни организации, за които говорят, тук могат да идват младежи, чужденци и не само, но и тях да включиме, които за тях да... Ти ще го редуцираш, така или иначе. За тях ще бъде изключително полезно да дойдат тук за доброволчества, да получат сертификати, в които те да пише, нали, те са работили върху добра кауза, нали, това. Изстрелва CV-то ти от тук, ето тук. Това е добре за доброволците. А за хората тук е добре изобщо движението, което се случва. Постоянното движение, ще идват хора. Те може да имат заможни родители, да кажете и там, ако знаете какво райско кътче има, те да решат да инвестират и така нататък.
Може
да го интерпретираш.
All local people should be included in the process and especially the younger local people because they're most important and they should be there could be some exchanges between the local young people from Djibouti and the people from other parts of the country and the world, also young people, who will exchange ideas and practices and
Ще практикуваш доброволчество, което е добре за бъдеща работа.
So the volunteers from somewhere else who come to Djibouti, their volunteering will be good for their future because they will get good references and all.
Още повече.
And they will learn more about the region and they will learn some practices, maybe like carpet weaving, something like that.
Още повече съвсем модерно е, когато нали, хората от така наречения модерен свят се включват в природни практики, да го наречем. Това, за което всички говорихме, можем да ги научим да тъкат килими, да работят в градина и така нататък. Това е супер модерно. В момента, в който се представи по един подходящ начин, ще заработи страхотно.
So if coming to Chipovci and doing traditional Chipovci stuff is presented in the right way, it's advertised and all of this, then it will become somehow fashionable for young people to come here and to learn this stuff, and the heritage will be preserved.
Maybe she said that it is very fashionable in nowadays in all Europe,
and
maybe in all world.
And
if it's good advertising, this fashion works for us.
Sorry,
the important thing she said is that people that come here to volunteer will be able to put it in their CV. When they go to apply for a job, say, look,
yeah,
I did this and this and this.
Good reference.
So it's good for them as a prestige if you...
They have good reference in their CV.
So if...
I think you can put it also in your list.
Yes, we can put, if you want, we can put this in this point, resources. Because the volunteers are a big resource for the organization. Because you don't pay to volunteers. They came with their truth.
They came with their skills, but they regain other ones.
Of course,
yeah. I mean that there is a different in the structure there are different parts. So we can put volunteers in our representation in this part that resources.
I think it was not her idea. It was an idea what we are going to do in this center. It is like that. One of the things, maybe not only, but one of the things that would be very useful and helpful for us, and to make some kind of courses for volunteers, for some kind of certification, that it will be very useful for their CV.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And this is one of I also agree with you that is one other part of our structure, but it's not only resource.
Mm-hmm.
It's a main work what we're going to do.
So like in the methods.
Well, not only courses for students or for students from Skarfask high schools, but also courses for volunteers.
Mm.
It's one of our topic what we are going to do in this seminar.
Yeah.
It's a way where...
is it like that? Have I translated it?
Maybe.
It's a huge way in NGOs and associations.
Mm-hmm.
That to make value to the people they work for and for almost free, they give certification skills that can say, okay, we are making a 1 week training for students, for foreigners, whatever. And because you were part of the organization, you have new skills for organizing, logistic, mobility, checking people together. And this is skills that they will bring back to their own life. It's different skills, different certification, parallel certification.
But it is almost the same like students from high school, and maybe not only students, maybe some other people. It depends on the topic also.
Whatever the topic.
Mm-hmm.
The volunteers, you give them notoriety and skills value by showing that they worked and they gain experience And so they can do it after in a, for other organization, other trainings, even in private companies in the future.
And I think you in this part of the our work now, I have a new idea, excuse me. Maybe on the end of the presentation of any one of us, he could ask what of these ideas are already done now in Djibouti by our travel university or by the local people. Because one of us, maybe Dimitra, knows that some kind of things are already done. Maybe not in this scale what we are dreaming it, but it was some kind of beginning. Because we make such kind of certification at all, and we have volunteers here also from the high school.
Yeah.
And you can have your own certification and put it in your CV. Because Dimitra also will put it in his CV during when he wants to go to the university in Britain. Is it so?
She.
Okay.
Also something. What we can use when you said resources, we can get trainees, like student practices and stuff.
Сега ли го видя?
Той
тук стои от някакъв
час.
The spider is here since Sunday.
Yeah. Since we got here. Стажанти, може да си вземем програми на университета.
Да, точно това искам да кажа, че ние можем...
Trainees from young people that come as trainees, as student practices, we can use that as a resource.
Другото, което искам да кажа, че в момента има изключително много финансирани програми и фондации, които, ето, например, аз съм в АНСЕК и там е имало набиране на чуждестранни доброволци, с цел, нали, те са три, или Culture Understanding, или Career Development, или Ecologic. И за екология имам паднала програмата, защото някак си така станало, че нямало къде да пращат чуждестранните доброволци, тук с цел екология. И аз мисля, че, нали, не говоря точно за ISET, за всякакви такива неща. Студентските практики на МОН, например, съвсем спокойно организаторите на Катурския университет могат да се регистрират дори в момента като организация, която набира стажанти. Стажантите ще дойдат, защото на тях им се заплачат 480 лева. Смисъл, не заради това, смисъл, изреждам го просто. Отделно, нали, те ще си получат сертификати и така нататък. Смисъл, идеята е не да направим някакви неща, които са статични. В смисъл, моята лична идея не е да направим някакви неща, които са статични, като, нали, да знаем, че тук ще се преподава така, че тук ще се преподава това и това. Трябва, според мен, една постоянна циркулация на хора, най-различни, от всякъде, с нови идеи, с фреш ер. Фреш ер.
Това е хората, викаш ли, аз те има и жена и
The idea is that
circulation of people in the future scenario is... Аз понеже се сетих за нещо, което мога да кажа на английски. Извинявай.
Не, не ще казвай, аз просто си кажа.
So circulation of people.
Circulation of people, young people from different organizations, like our Ministry for Education, and now it is making traineeships. In which the organizers of the traveling university can make their own something like profile there, and with this profile they can attract trainees, students trainees, and also students in schools, and I'm talking about circulation of people, exchanging with foreigners, with students from our country, and just to search a foundation.
Good news is I'm staying with you.
That can finance this. Financing, it's a big topic, I think. That can finance, and that can...
Sustain support.
That can... sustain support for the advertising. If we work
but you know, if Bulgarian, we work, hiding.
It's flowing in my mind.
If we work with another organizations like our partners and organizations educational like New Bulgaria University and the French Culture Institute, and if we involve international foundations like ISEC or IAC or something like this, we're going to achieve very much. I know so many young people that are great and they want to do many things. They want to, I know one Vietnam girl which is living in Bulgaria and she really loves Bulgaria, and I'm sure that if I tell her about these things here, our ideas, she's from my sex, she'll be just wow. And I'm sure if we and advertisement, I'm not talking about this.
Okay, if we can add something to this, because we can add this just to this structure now.
Well, this is maybe what you, I heard on the last your words. It's something connected with the topic for tomorrow. How we could
improve
in reality. One of the things is this is my maybe the point of the financing, the managing of our center.
And also we should correct here that I read that this is for growing children. I mean for young people, not for only for growing children. For young people
as a whole.
Okay.
It gives me an idea, because what you say is real and it's already a fact. Mm-hmm. You know, there is a student from Korea, from China, from all over the world. There is, we can improve, reinforce it. We can advertise for more people. And it gave me an idea that maybe...
excuse me, they began to talk with each other because they don't understand what we are discussing.
No, I'm saying what
not
we're
quite
about
sure.
We're just talking about how we need money and how we need young people, but we're not discussing what we're going to do in this seminar in this
but
building.
But it's not true. Come and told us some example what we could do there.
Okay, also we said that we wouldn't interrupt each other. Like one person talks and she talks, then stops, and then the other comes, and she talks, you start talking, and it's like yesterday. So, you won't do anywhere.
Okay, then we can continue.
Добре, Души.
Аз просто искам да обобщя, защото днес може би много разхвърляли неща. Искам да обобщя, че според мен, според зависимост в каква структура се направят нещата от организаторите и така нататък, би било много хубаво, ако или се появи някой нов човек или нещо такова, който започне да се занимава с такъв обмен, нали, той да прокарва нещата стажове и доброволчества и по този начин да се получава циркулацията на хората. You look at me like you understand me. Is it scary?
I feel like I understand.
A young person who organizes trainees and volunteers who can come here.
Responsible people.
Young person.
Yeah. The point is we can separate like two similar training. A training for people who want to know more about nature, to improve, to make farming, to make construction design, And we can, in the same way, making training for people who want to be sustainer, to be organizer, to be a professional volunteer. You know? So we can cross all these two
trails. Can we mix them together?
Of course. You just give them separate tasks and separate objectives, and at the end you give them separate certification.
Okay. That would
But it's
and maybe
I mean we do it at the university all the time.
And maybe some of the people would want to make the first tasks and then the
and
second.
They come back for for the second one.
And they have
so this
two
is
yes,
the double
of course.
Win. Yeah, of
and
course.
If we have partners, they will have a certification from the traveling university, from maybe New Bulgarian University, maybe the French Cultural Institute, and maybe
from
an organization like
ISA. They have, they could have a certificate also for the municipality.
Yeah.
Yes,
good.
It will
useful
be mixed
also.
And very useful for everybody.
And it leads me to my to my idea you gave me. It's maybe it could be also useful for public administration or ministries or services to or official organization like a Greenpeace or WWF.
Mm-hmm.
You want to know more about how to train volunteers, how to learn about environment and sustainable development. Come to the center, European Learning Center. To improve yourself, you are a Ministry of Environment, of a construction site, Ministry of Transport. You want to do better for your own country. Come here, and you will you will be trained. Even in France, sometimes it's not so easy. So it could be really great.
I think so.
And you can do Bulgarian trainings, English trainings, and whatever trainings. I mean,
you're great.
It's a point that in 5 years you can have automatic findings for it.
Yes.
When you train official administrators.
That's my main
it's,
idea.
It's good. So that's it's great.
One of the things that we could do, connect, interconnected with all others.
And you asked me for my ideas. As a sustainer, I would not, but I will. Because of the history of Chiprovti and this art, really precious art center that almost disappeared, it could be impressive, massive, to collect all the archive material, the art they made, built there, to make to digitalize it and to make it into a kind of a big book that if you want to know about design, sustainable design, natural design, you come here on the or on the website. And you know everything in the world we can collect with a new official website tools, and we can have kind of a corpus of everything in the world what we can do for sustainable development, for mobility, for housing, for learning, for everything, for art. And so it's one part, it's more the structure, the process, the economical model for the sustainability of the center, to say this is how value, we are capitalizing all the skills and the learning we are sharing together and we are offering to the trainers and the volunteers. And by the way, because Chiprovti has got the UNESCO label, which if when I am traveling, when I'm traveling in the city, I don't see it, so
as
I don't know. And so, but we can use it to ask. It's it's also another work, maybe for 5 years, but in Dijon, we have what we call a UNESCO share. There is a lot in the world. And for example, in Dijon, it's about wine. So everything you want to know about wine, winery, vineyard, wine history, wine making, whatever wine you want.
Wine drinking.
It's you can know it in Dijon. And even in California, in Australia, in Bordeaux, they are pissed off because it's in Dijon. And the girl who made it, she spent half her life to do it alone. And at the end, with the support of everybody, university, and there is a UNESCO process. Now, there is an international training center about wine in Dijon. And so maybe she before she's got retired, because she's 70 years old, but really active, it could be interesting to invite her or her colleagues or to go to see her to ask her how she did it, to do it the same with sustainable design, for example. We can apply I think because of carpet, because of housing, permaculture, and so on, I try to find a top topic, main topic that could include the other ones. And sustainable design, I didn't make a benchmarking, worldwide benchmarking, but it's maybe a main topic that could be useful. Like, you know, they use natural color plants, they have their own design. We can you can share the design for housing, depends of the sun, of the elements, and so on, with natural elements to build a house. Sustainable design could be maybe interesting.
This is your idea about our work, or it was yes. Thank you very much, Frank. And you said something that for me is very important, because of this story of this woman who made this in Dijon. Because we are used to think that something just fall from the sky, but the real thing in the life, it's a process, and this process is made by the real human being, that they're struggling for it, that they just give their life for it, not to die, but to live with another people, but they give his energy and his purpose in the life for this. And something happened here in Ciprozzi, with Ciprozzi carpet, because the carpet in UNESCO is not falling from the sky. You know, it was made here by a lot of people, and not only by one people, and maybe by people working in groups together in community. And it's very important to know it and to share it, and for us to ask, which are these people, who are these people that they that make this thing happen. Yeah. Because when you know how the story was, how it happens, why it happens, who did it, you can work with this one together. For this seminarium and for all the city. And we are watching the reality as we are watching TV. We think something virtual, something happened somewhere. But it's not somewhere. It's here, and it's made by real people. And some of our groups now going in the streets and asking old people and everyone they meet on the streets. Other part of our groups are now in by the mayor and they speak with the mayor. Do you understand what I mean?
But we are all acting in different ways.
What?
Maybe we should speak with these people twice. Sorry. The other groups are doing it.
Maybe we could speak with another ones. Maybe with these who managed to make the carpet UNESCO heritage.
Who is this person?
Maybe we could ask someone in Cyprus who did it, who was in the process of making it. Yeah, well, I know it, but is it my work to tell you? I know it, but I'm not quite sure who was there. You know the most of these people, Dimitra. You know the active people in Cyprusy, really. You know who they are. You have saw the movie about made for UNESCO by Ivan Georgiev of New Bulgarian University, the movie about the Cyprusy carpet as a UNESCO heritage. It's some kind of advertising movie before they decided to put the carpet in UNESCO. It was a selection, and for this selection they made the movies for the different topics that they are in some kind of
competition.
Which of them will be the heritage. And you know who was in this movie of the Cyprusy persons, of the people. If they were in this movie, maybe, and I'm absolutely sure, they were part of the process.
Okay.
Learn to think.
I just asked who is the specific person who, because you said that there is one.
But you know,
person.
You can tell me which of these persons you know. You can tell me.
But you said there is one person who did it. That's why
I didn't say that. I said not
do
only
have,
one.
Do we have enough time to talk to them?
Yeah, exactly.
I said not only one as in Dijon, but a group of people, a community of people that did it.
Okay. So
all
the importance of community,
Frank,
not the individual.
Are you finished with?
Yeah.
Okay. So
nowadays,
community.
Petre, well, okay, you are on the
floor. We give
okay.
the floor.
I give you an idea to share with us, which are the people in Cyprus. Yeah. Which are the important people?
I
didn't
have a zapis.
Okay. So you three basically covered all the important ideas. And I already shared my main idea yesterday, which was that local people should teach at this seminarium. Everyone should teach what they know. Like a carpet weaver teaches carpet weaving. A carpet coloring person should teach.
Covering,
yes, and so on, and this is my idea, and also that people who volunteers and university professors and anyone who wants to can come here and teach local people what they know, and this is the process of exchange. So this is my main idea, and also.
If you want to, the idea will
also
come back.
I have an idea about how our presentation should be should be presented, because we have to talk about that too, and we don't have the time to make a PowerPoint presentation. So maybe we can make something on that.
Okay, but it's not so important to make it like in PowerPoint. The main thing for me is who can do it, because I can't do it.
I can write it down.
He is very good in presentations.
No, this is why I'm telling you, let's not make a PowerPoint presentation.
Yeah.
Let's make something else, like, for example, we can use a whiteboard to write on it.
Yes.
The main, the specific topics and ideas. Or we can, if there isn't a whiteboard, where would the presentation
be? We can manage to have a whiteboard,
okay,
it's important for
we
us.
We can use a
paper.
Big piece of paper, but it has to be a giant one. I mean, we can't just use a regular one. So, and also I had an idea about maybe one of the topics that we discussed yesterday about the symbols and their importance. I have an idea about the video that we can make, and if you want to, if all of you want to take part in it, that would be great. But otherwise, I thought of us three that we can make this video, and some of you can
shoot.
Some of you can shoot, and the video will be could be presented at the beginning or at the end of our presentation, like some kind of a refreshing thing that is not so serious and everything. And my idea is that this video could be something like the three of us, or if some of you wants to join with another language, because we're doing it with languages, we are foreigners. Vesti could be a Bulgarian. We want to be a Bulgarian.
Okay.
Okay, so Vesti is a Bulgarian, for example. Ellie is Chinese. I'm Polish.
You are?
Can be French. Or if I know another language.
Scottish.
No. Me can be Russian with my English.
And Kamen could be
a
local one.
No, Vesti is a local one.
Oh, you are the from Chile.
So, in some of you can shoot whatever. It's just the idea of the video is that you, we are on the street. We see a sign that we don't know. First, for example, comes Vesti. She doesn't know how to get to the. No, she's not a local one. She doesn't know how. Okay, she doesn't know how to get somewhere. And she says in Bulgarian, of ne znam kak da stigne
do.
And then she sees this sign that is not in a specific language, it's just a sign of the place she wants to get to. And she says something like, she goes to the place. Then there comes Ellie. And she says, repeats the same thing in Chinese. She sees the sign, she goes there. Then I come. I repeat the same thing in English and so on in different languages. Like, this is video is supposed to show how people from different countries can understand a simple sign. And maybe the Chinese girl can come at last and says, we, the Chinese, we use symbols. No, or not. Okay, whatever. And then at the end of the video, someone can go and say something like, this is the importance of symbols. Symbols are useful, could be useful for anyone. Symbols could be useful for people from all over the world to understand themselves. And one of the most unique and the oldest symbols in the world are the symbols on the chip of tea carpets.
Mm.
So we can shoot this video if you want, or we three can just shoot it and we can present it at the beginning or at the end of our presentation.
Right idea.
It would be very funny and.
I don't know if you want to join, if you don't want to, but even if you don't want to, we can do it.
I'm Vladimira. I came from Russia.
Yeah, and my other idea was about the logo with the board. so we just draw it and that's it. Nelly, your turn.
My turn. I completely agree with you about your ideas, and I think the idea for having local people teaching their crafts and what they know is wonderful. And we can, if we have this building as a seminarium, we can have like classes, but more interesting and more fun, and with a lot of practice in them, not just theory, but mainly just doing it. And I also think the idea, the previous ideas were also great, and totally approve. And I think I can help in this team by helping with the video, and just probably give some ideas about how to